Well, it's kind of a funny story. Back when I was 2 weeks before I turned 16, I got home from school and my mom said, "All right, Todd, put on your coat and tie and we're gonna go out." I go, "Oh, okay, we having a mom and son date night day." And she goes, "Oh no, it's time for you to get a job. You're gonna be 16 in 2 weeks. You need to start earning a living. Do you wanna work grocery stores or do you wanna work restaurants?" And I chose restaurants. So my first job was in St. Louis, Missouri at a family-owned restaurant, and I was hired in as a busboy. And then about 3 months later, I was promoted to head busboy, in which I hired, fired, and trained all the other busboys.
Wow.
Yeah, it was quite an experience, and Harry was a great mentor. Really got me a lot of knowledge, taught me the way of the business, the personal skills, and I loved his interaction with all of his regular clients.
Right.
So that really set my career off on that path.
Yeah, there's always that special person in the beginning of your career that kind of really inspires you and keeps you moving.
Yes, absolutely. And that's when I really discovered that I had the restaurant business in my blood. When I worked there all through college, actually. But after I graduated high school, I was thinking I was going to be going into computer science.
Right.
Tried to fool myself a little bit and wanted a more regular, steady job. And that didn't work out too well for me because my math skills weren't quite there.
Right.
And I just found myself going back into hospitality. So at the University of Missouri, I wanted to be a little bit more well-rounded and set myself aside. So I got a degree in general studies where I'm 6 credits short of an individual degree in psychology, business management, and hospitality management. So that really set me aside and helped me become a little bit more well-rounded.
That's fantastic. That really is. And so when you came out of college, what was your next move?
Well, actually, my senior year of college, I helped the Alumni Center move from its local location, or from its current location then, to a brand new building in which they had banquet spaces and a club-like restaurant. So I was the opening front of house manager there, in which I really got to build that up, order the china, glassware, silverware, and really be involved in that concept from the ground up. And there, Tom Guthrie was a great mentor and kind of showed me the business planning and how to manage the finances a little bit more. And then I really started to understand the leadership skills that I really needed to be successful. So that was a great move for me, and right time, right place, and it worked out very, very well for me.
After that experience, I mean, how long did you stay on the hospitality side, you know, the restaurant side?
In typical fashion during that time, about every 3 to 5 years, you either moved up or moved out.
Right.
They ended up eliminating my position after 3 years and kind of breaking it apart and giving it to some students in their hospitality program. So I moved back to St. Louis and worked hotels for a little bit. I did not like hotels. The hours were horrendous. I literally worked 114 hours 2 weeks in a row, and that's when I had enough.
Right.
And then I decided I wanted to do something different. I was long distance dating a nice woman in Kansas City and moved to Kansas City, worked at Chi-Chi's, and then every 3 to 5 years again, kind of worked my way around. Chi-Chi's, I was the youngest GM in the corporation, and then went to a grocery store for a little bit, went back to Chi-Chi's, went to a couple other restaurants. And then at Jose Pepper's, one of my regulars was Rodney McBride, who is the Vice President of Health Services here. He and I became friends. I had a relative at the time that was the human resource manager, and I found out that John Knox right down the street was looking for a restaurant director. And I applied and got the job, and thankfully I did, and here I am 14 years later.